Determine which graphs represent one-to-one functions. Well, first of all, we have to recall the definition of a one-to-one function. A one-to-one function has two important characteristics. Number one, equal inputs always have the same output. And number two, equal outputs always have the same input. To check and see if a graph satisfies the first condition, we could apply the vertical line test. The vertical line test says that if every vertical line intersects the graph at most once, then the graph is a function. In other words, each input will have exactly one output. So let's check graph A. When x is negative, a vertical line passes through the graph exactly once. When x is 0, a vertical line passes through the graph exactly once. When x is positive, a vertical line passes through the graph exactly once. Every vertical line passes through graph A at most once, so graph A is the graph of a function. For graph B, we see that if x is negative, a vertical line either does not pass through the graph, or a vertical line passes through the graph exactly once. When x is equal to 0, a vertical line passes through the graph exactly once. When x is positive, a vertical line passes through the graph exactly once, or not at all. Every vertical line passes through graph B and at most one point, so graph B is also the graph of a function. Similarly, graphs C and D are also functions. All the graphs pass the vertical line test, so all the graphs satisfy the first condition. Equal inputs always have the same output. To check and see if the second condition is met, we can apply the horizontal line test. The horizontal line test says that if every horizontal line intersects the graph of a function at most once, then that function is a one-to-one function. So let's check graph A. For graph A, we see that when y is negative, the horizontal line intersects the graph exactly once. When y is equal to 0, the horizontal line intersects the graph exactly once. And when y is positive, a horizontal line intersects the graph exactly once. Every horizontal line intersects graph A exactly once, so graph A is a one-to-one function. What about graph B? Well, when x is negative, we see that a horizontal line might not intersect the graph at all. Or a horizontal line might intersect the graph at one point. But we see that it's also possible for a horizontal line to intersect the graph at more than one point. This particular horizontal line intersects the graph at two points. These two points have equal outputs, but they have different inputs. Therefore, it is not the case that equal outputs always have the same input. Graph B does not pass the horizontal line test, and therefore, it is not a one-to-one function. What about graph C? Is it possible to draw a horizontal line that passes through the graph more than once? Well, yes, it is. So graph C does not pass the horizontal line test either, and it is not one-to-one. Finally, we take a look at graph D. A horizontal line might intersect the graph at 2 points, or 4 points, or 3 points. The key thing is that we can find a horizontal line that passes through the graph more than once. Therefore, graph D does not pass the horizontal line test. It is not one-to-one. So which graphs represent one-to-one functions? Well, A only. A is the correct answer.